بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي لا يبلغ مدحته القائلون ولا يحسين ماءه الآدون ولا يؤدي حقه المجتهدون الذي لا يدركه بعد الحمم ولا يناله غوث الفتن الذي ليس لصفته حد محدود ولا نعت موجود ولا وقت معدود ولا أجل ممدود فترى الخلائق بقدرته ونشر الرياح برحمته. اللهم أفس صلة صلواتك وسلامة تسليماتك على أفضل التعينات المفاضة من العماء رباني وآخر التنزلات المضافة إلى نوع الإنسان. كان الله ولم يكن معه شيء ثاني محصي لعوالم حضرات الخمس في وجوده وكل شيء أحسيناه في إمام المبين. ما صلى على محمد وآل محمد. الرسول النبي المكي الخرشي المدني التحامي صاحب لواء الحمد ومقام المحمود عبد القاسم محمد الحميد وعلى أخيه وسهره وخليفته من بعده وقائد الغر المحجلين ياسب الدين إمام المتقين أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب وعلى ابنته الطاهرة الحوراء الإنسية الراضية المرضية الشفية يوم الجزاء فاطمة الزهراء سلام الله عليها وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المظلومين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين من يومنا هذا إلى قيام يوم الدين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنما وليكم الله ورسوله والذين آمنوا الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم راكعون. صلوات
I begin in the name of Allah, the most beneficent and most merciful. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are in the blessed month of Ramadan in which the doors of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are opened for those who are seeking Allah's mercy. They are opened for those who are seeking Allah's forgiveness. They are opened for those who are seeking Allah's qurb and closeness by attaining and striving towards taqwa. Now one thing that is very, very crucial and very, very critical that inshallah in the coming nights we are going to discuss, that Islam talks about zawahir and also batin. You find apparent outlook that needs to be presentable in accordance with Islamic values. But there is a batin also behind it. And the ultimate goal is batin. The ultimate goal is the inward result or the inward outcome of that outward ritual that you are performing. I might have mentioned before also how even our ibadat, they have an outward apparent value, but there is an inward batini value, which is the essence of that ibadah, which is the essence of that worship. And if that is not attained through the apparent and through the zahir, then our ibadat could be gone to waste.
So therefore, we need to strive keeping our goal ahead. Just merely going on a freeway with one of the fastest car on the road will not lead you to a destination. You have to have a goal. So our worships, our taqwa has a goal. That ultimate goal is the qurb of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But to attain that qurb, we have to attain the rida of Rasulullah. We have to attain the pleasure of Rasulullah. And to attain the pleasure of Rasulullah, the Prophet of Allah says that ana madinatul ilm wa aliyun babuha. Muhammad wa Ali. Those who are trying to come to me being the city of knowledge, then they have to enter the city of knowledge through the door or through the gate of the city of knowledge. And that is no one else but Amirul Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib. So the batin that we have to strive in our ritual forms of worship, my dear brothers and sisters, is to attain the wilaya of Ahlul Bayt. If we could attain the wilaya of Ahlul Bayt, we would attain the wilaya of Rasulullah. And if we attain the wilaya of Rasulullah, we will surely attain the wilaya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the verse of Holy Quran I had the honor of reciting is pointing into this direction. When it says, innama waliyukumullah, indeed only and only your guardian, your wali is Allah, wa rasuluhu, and his prophet is your wali. And then from there onwards, the verse of Holy Quran is describing a trait, is describing a quality. Whoever fits into that trait, whoever fits into that quality would be the wali that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is appointing, and it's a clear verse of Holy Quran. What is the description of the wali other than Allah and other than the Holy Prophet? The description is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allazina amanu, and then those who are believers. And what do they do? وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الَّذِينَ يُخِيمُونَ السَّلَاةِ. They are the ones who establishes salat. Amongst the believers, your wali is those believers who establishes the salat. وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةِ, and they pay the zakat, the poor rate. وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ, while they are in the state of bowing, in the state of ruku. Now when you go and look into the verse of Holy Quran, who was the mizdaq of this verse of Holy Quran? Here the plural has been used, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those believers. So there is a plural as if there are many, many people in the history of Islam whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is appointing. But what has Allah done? Allah had given two traits that are the qualifiers. If they are fulfilled, then and only then that person could become the wali, the guardian, as Allah is guardian and as Rasulullah is guardian. Allahumma salli ala. Now this guardianship is not mere guardianship like we are wali of those who are under our guardianship. A daughter's wali is her father. When a daughter is given in hand in marriage, you will find that the Maulana would call and say, who's the wali? Call the wali, I need to get the permission. Right? So the wali, the guardian in that sense, is the father. Now here in this verse of Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, innama waliyukumullah. Innama is mufid hasr. Innama rounds off and isolates, showing that only and only the people I am mentioning, they are the only one who are due to the trait that is being described. Just like innama yuridullah. There also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying only and only it is the desire of Allah that he would keep impurities away from Ahlul Bayt as the due is upon them. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. So we find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing that his wilaya is the absolute wilaya. His guardianship is the absolute guardianship. And Allah is saying, I am your guardian. I am the only guardian of yours. And then there is an atf. Atf, what does it do? It says and. Those of us who know logic and or operators, whether you use it in math or in computer science, you know when you have and, all the conditions have to be true before the whole statement is true. If it is or, you need only one. If it was aw in Arabic, like innama waliyukumullah aw rasuluhu, means your wali is Allah or your wali is Rasul. No, here there is an and, meaning your wali has to be Allah, then your wali has to be Rasulullah, and then your wali has to be those believers who establishes salat and who pay zakat in the state of ruku. Please recite salawat. So this is an explicit ayah. This is an explicit ayah mentioning the wilaya of those believers who establish a salat and who pay the poor rate in the state of ruku. And when you go and look into the history, when you look into the riwayah of the Shan-e-Nuzul, the mizdaq of this ayah was only and only one person, being Amir al-Mu'mineen. There were people, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa alim. There were people who tried to give zakat in the state of ruku and they did it for 40 days and there was no endorsement that was revealed to the Holy Prophet. So there was only one instance of this to which this ayah is referring. Now let me share with you a hadith itself which talks about how this ayah was revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please say the salawat. Here the Prophet of Allah is seen that poor man, a miskeen, who comes to the door of the masjid and then he is asking for charity and there is no response. So now the poor man starts addressing God loudly and saying, Allahumma ishhad inni sa'altu fi masjidi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Oh Allah, you be the witness that I have requested for charity in the mosque of Rasulullah. Wa lam yu'tini ahadun shay'a. And nobody gave me anything. I am in your messenger's mosque and nobody, and I'm asking for charity and nobody is giving me. And then the narration says, وَكَانَ عَلِيٌّ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ رَاكِعًا. Amir al-Mu'mineen, Imam Ali alayhi salam, was seen at that time to be in the state of ruku. He was reciting salat and he was in the state of ruku. And the narration continues and it says that the Imam gave him permission by extending his hand in the state of ruku so that the person, the caller, realized that he is asking me to take away the ring that the Imam was wearing. And the person reaches Amir al-Mu'mineen and takes the ring and Amir al-Mu'mineen continues his salat. This is what the incident that occurred, and this was witnessed. The Prophet of Allah saw this, and then now the Prophet of Allah is calling for Allah, and the Prophet of Allah is making dua and he's saying, Allahumma inna akhi Musa sa'alaka. Oh Allah, my brother Musa, Hazrat Musa, had asked you رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من اهلي. او الله, Hazrat Musa, this is the dua of Hazrat Musa in the Holy Quran, in which Musa calls upon Allah and says, O my Lord, open my breast, open my chest for me, make my affairs easy for me, remove the hitch from my tongue. Musa used to stammer, or when he would speak, people would not understand. So here Musa is asking that not only he can communicate, but that communication is receptible to people, and then so that they may understand my call, my discourse. And then Hazrat Musa says, "Waj'al li waziram min ahli." O Allah, appoint for me a wazir, a deputy, a minister for me from my ahl, from my family. This is the dua of Hazrat Musa. And who is doing this dua? Rasulullah, when he saw this incident that Hazrat Ali gave the ring in zakat, in the state of ruku, Rasulullah, when he witnessed it, he is calling upon Allah and he's saying, Oh Allah, my brother Musa had made this dua that, Oh Allah, make sure that you open up and you expand my chest, meaning give me, provide me the wisdom that is needed for me to speak, and make my speech such that it would be receptible. And then Hazrat Musa says, O Allah, appoint for me my deputy from my ahl, from my family. And then he does not stop there, that you can appoint whoever you want. You know, everybody is, you know, equal. They are all my family. So you can appoint anybody. Like you find, like it is said, Sahaba, they are all equal. You can just go off and pick anybody, which is not true. But here we find Hazrat Musa is very, very explicit. He says that, O Allah, the appointment that I am calling for is Haruna Akhi. O Allah, appoint for me a wazir from my family, and that person is Harun, my brother. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being called upon. Why? Return on investment. When you do a project, you define the need, you define the mission, and then you say, what are the returns? Well, how are you going to benefit from the investment that you are making? Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being told by Hazrat Musa that if this happens, what does it do? It will strengthen my back through him and make him my associate in my affairs. So now Hazrat Musa not only wants himself to be representing Allah, he wants his brother to be appointed his deputy and made a partner in the affairs that Musa is going to conduct. And that affairs is to go off against Tahut, go off and fight against the shaitan of that time, to ensure that Bani Israel is guided to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we find this is the dua of Hazrat Musa. And who is quoting in this narration? Rasulullah is recalling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Oh Allah, my brother Musa had made this dua to make Harun, to appoint Harun as his deputy, so that through him the back of Musa is going to be reinforced and strengthened, and he would become a partner in affairs of Hazrat Musa. The affairs of Hazrat Musa is the task of Nubuwa, the task of spreading the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Prophet of Allah says, O Allah, you heard Hazrat Musa and you responded to him. And then he narrates another verse of Holy Quran, Surah Qasas, verse 35. Sanashuddu azudaka bi'akhika wa naj'alu lakuma sultanan fala yasiluna ilaykuma. What did you do, Allah? The Prophet of Allah is saying, recalling the verse of Holy Quran, Oh Allah, he said, we will, meaning Allah said, we will strengthen your arm by means of your brother and invest both of you with such authority that they will not touch you.
اللهم صل على Who is saying all this? The Prophet of Allah is saying all this, recalling at an incident that occurred when a poor man calls for charity and nobody responds. Amir al-Mu'mineen is in the state of ruku and he extends his hand and the poor man takes the ring from the hand of Amir al-Mu'mineen and Rasulullah witnesses it and then calls upon Allah and he is making a dua. In which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being recalled by Rasulullah and saying that Musa, my brother, had made this dua to you, O Allah, to not only expand his chest, not only to give him the speech that would be receptive, but also to appoint for him a deputy who is going to be from his family, and that is Harun, my brother. And through him, he will strengthen my back, and also through him, he would be the partner in my affairs. And then Rasulullah says, O Allah, you responded to this call of Hazrat Musa by saying the words that I just recited, in which the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we will strengthen your arm by means of your brother and invest both of you with such authority that they will not touch you. So now the mandate, the divine mandate, does not stop at Hazrat Musa. The divine mandate extends even to Hazrat Harun. Hazrat Musa initiated the conversation, but Allah had approved it. And Allah's approval is with the reinforcement of the strength that Allah is going to provide, not only to Hazrat Musa, but also to Hazrat Harun. Hazrat Rasulullah is quoting all this in his dua to finally come to these words in which he says, Allahumma wa ana Muhammadu Nabiyyik. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadu. وَسَفِيِّكْ O Allah, I am your prophet and your messenger. اللَّهُمَّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي. Now, Hazrat Rasulullah is also quoting the same verses of the Holy Quran and saying what Moses, Hazrat Musa, had said and saying, O Allah, expand my chest. وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي. And make it easy for my affairs. وَاجْعَلْ لِي وَزِيرًا مِنْ أَهْلِي. O Allah, appoint for me a deputy from my ahl, from my family. Aliyan. Salawat ala Muhammad wa Allah. Ushdud bihi zahri. And through him make my back strong, O Allah. So the Rasulullah is using the verses of Holy Quran and repeating the verses or the words that Hazrat Harun, Hazrat Musa had called upon with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by changing the name from Harun to Amir al-Mu'mineen. When this is done, Abu Zar Ghaffari says that I swear by Allah. Now Abu Zar is taking, he's swearing to emphasize that he's telling the truth. The Prophet had not finished this dua. Jibrail came and Jibrail said, O Prophet, recite. And Rasulullah said, what should I recite? And then Jibrail repeated the verses and Rasulullah repeated after him, إِنَّمَا وَلِيُّكُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ صَلَوَاتٌ. Indeed, your wali is Allah and his messenger and those believers who establishes prayers and give zakat in the state of ruku. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is the riwayah in which we find that how explicitly the Prophet of Allah had and the whole unfolding of events are showing what is meant by wilaya. That deputyship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had granted to Hazrat Harun and strengthened Hazrat Musa with Harun, the same deputyship was granted to Amir al-Mu'mineen. And the narrations of this sort are available in books of all the mazahib.
These are not narrations coming from just our books. In all mazhab, in fact, there are even narrations that reiterate. If you look into the book of Nisa'i, Nisa'i is one of the authors of Siha Sitta. The Sahih books that our brothers of Ahl Sunnah have, one of the six books is written by Nisa'i, and Nisa'i has also written a book called Qisas-e Amirul Mu'mineen. This is the narrations he had compiled for Amirul Mu'mineen to show and describe the fazilat and the superiority of Amirul Mu'mineen. And it has an historical context. The historical context was that Bani Umayyah were from pulpits, from the sermons of Jum'ah, they were cursing Amirul Mu'mineen, and Nisa'i could not withstand this injustice that was being occurred not only to the personality of Amirul Mu'mineen but also to deviate believers from the wilaya of Amirul Mu'mineen. And in for that purpose Nisa'i stood up and compiled the book which is Qisas-e Amirul Mu'mineen, after which he was asked to write another book praising another one of Bani Umayyah, and he declined, and one of the causes of his death were because he did not write that book. This is how history has unfolded. The wilaya of Amirul Mu'mineen was very, very clearly written on the pages of history, on the pages of Quran, on the pages of Seerah, on the pages of ulama and fuqaha and mufassireen who were looking up for truth. And this truth was being deviated or shifted only to serve the purpose of shayateen. Because if the batin of all our worship would be attained, then and only then we would be successful. And shaitan has promised that I will not let you succeed so easily. And therefore this was all done. In the interest of time, I have only 5 more minutes. In the interest of time, I need to move fast. And for matam also, please say salawat. We find that there are narrations in the holy month of Ramadan. When in the beginning of the holy month of Ramadan, I was mentioning the riwayah of the arrival of Ramadan and how the Prophet of Allah mentioned from our 8th Imam, the narration is, it actually goes all the way to Amirul Mu'mineen. And if the Imam was standing there, and then the Imam asks Rasulullah, when the Prophet of Allah ends his sermon, he asks, what is the best of action? Ma afzalul a'mal fi hadhihi shahr. What is the best action, O Prophet of Allah, in this blessed month? And Rasulullah responds by saying, Ya Abul Hasan, meaning Imam Ali, afzalul a'mal fi hadhihi shahr al-wara'u an maharim Allah. Rasulullah responds to Amirul Mu'mineen saying, the best action that you can perform during the holy month of Ramadan is to attain the quality of Vara. Vara is again parhezgari, bachna. Vara is again abstinence from things that have been prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, the narration continues, Summa baka wa khulto ya Rasulullah. Ma yubkika. And then the narration says that the Prophet of Allah started crying. And Amirul Mu'mineen starts asking him, O Prophet of Allah, why are you crying? فَقَالَ يَا عَلِيُّ عَبْقِي لِمَا يُسْتَحَلُّ مِنْكَ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ. O Ali, I am recalling of what is going to transpire and come about in this month upon you. كَأَنِّي بِكَ وَأَنْتَ تُسَلِّي لِرَبِّكَ وَقَدْ إِنْبَاسَ أَشْخَى الْأَوَّلِينَ وَآخِرِينَ شَخِيقٌ آخِرٌ. Here the Prophet of Allah is mentioning, O Ali, the worst, the most wretched person upon earth, while you are in the state of Salat, is going to attack upon you, O Ali. And he is going to make your beard turn into blood, O Ali. When the Amir al-Mu'mineen is being described by Rasulullah, his martyrdom, what does Amir al-Mu'mineen say to him? After hearing all this, he says, Ya Rasulullah, وَذَلِكَ فِي سَلَامَةٍ مِّن دِينِ. When this happens, O Rasulullah, will my religion be saved? Will my religion be secured? The Prophet of Allah responds, of course, Ya Ali. And the narration continues. Inshallah, I would continue. Azizo, aap se aaj us rozedar ka matam karna hai hum sab ko, jo Rasul ka sab se zyada aziz, Rasul ka sab se kharibi habib, رسول کا سب سے زیادہ چاہنے والا, رسول کا سب سے زیادہ ماننے والا, رسول کے دین کو سب سے زیادہ محفوظ رکھنے والا, اس کو جب پیغمبر فرماتے ہیں یا علی آپ اس دنیا سے چلے جاؤ گے, یا علی شقی ترین فرد آپ کی ریش مبارک کو خون سے رنگین کر دے گا, امیر المومنین فرماتے ہیں یا رسول اللہ کیا میرا دین سلامت رہے گا؟ اور اس پر یہی جواب ملتا ہے یا علی آپ کا دین سلامت رہے گا یا علی. اور اس کے بعد امیر المومنین کی پیغمبر فضیلتیں بیان کرتے ہیں. مجھے بہت ہی اختصار کے ساتھ عزیزو آپ کے سامنے رکھنا ہے, سترہ رمضان سے امیر المومنین بہت بے چین تھے. روایتیں بتاتی ہیں اس لیے کہ سترہ رمضان کو بدر کا معرکہ ہوا تھا, بار بار حسن سے امیر المومنین سوال کرتے تھے کہ آج رمضان کی کون سی تاریخ ہے, اور 18ویں کی رات یا شب 19 کو بہت مسترم تھے امیر المومنین. یہاں تک کہ افطار کے لیے ام کلثوم کے گھر جاتے ہیں اور وہاں پر جب افطار کرتے ہیں, بیٹی چاہتی ہے میرا بابا حاکم مملکت اسلامیہ ہے لیکن بہت محتاط ہے, ایک سے زیادہ نعمت کو جب سامنے رکھتی ہیں, شیر کو بھی رکھتی ہیں, دودھ کو بھی رکھتی ہیں, نمک کو بھی رکھتی ہیں, لیکن امیر المومنین فرماتے ہیں یا بیٹی تم نہیں جانتی میں دو نعمتیں یکساں تناول نہیں کرتا, ایک مرتبہ ام کلثوم چاہتی ہیں کہ نمک کو ہٹا لیں, لیکن عزیزو امیر المومنین اپنے ہاتھ سے دودھ کو دے دیتے ہیں. ام کلثوم دیکھ رہی ہے کہ مملکت اسلامیہ کا خلیفہ جو نمک سے افطار کر رہا ہے, ایک مرتبہ رات کی تاریکی بڑھتی چلی جاتی ہے اور امیر المومنین باہر اپنے حجرے سے آتے ہیں, آسمان کی طرف دیکھتے ہیں, حسن سے سوال کرتے ہیں, ارے وصال کا وقت آ گیا, ارے ملاقات کا وقت آ گیا. امیر المومنین کے قلب میں استراب کا عالم ہے. یہاں تک کہ وہ وقت بھی آتا ہے کہ اب مسجد کو جانا ہوتا ہے. ایک مرتبہ امیر المومنین چاہتے ہیں کہ مسجد کے لیے روانہ ہوئے, لیکن آپ سب جانتے ہیں عزیزوں مرغابیاں امیر المومنین کا دامن تھام لیتی ہے, مولا آج کی رات نہ جائیے مولا, دشمن زہر آلودہ تلوار سے آپ کا مسجد میں انتظار کر رہا ہے مولا. یہاں تک کہ در کی زنجیر بھی رک جاتی ہے اور مولا کو یاد دلاتی ہے, حسن سے وصیت کرتے ہیں مرغابیوں کا خیال رکھنا, اور یہاں تک کہ مسجد میں آ جاتے ہیں مستحبات کو انجام دینے کے لیے. پھر وہ وقت بھی آتا ہے کہ اذان کا وقت آ جاتا ہے, محراب میں جا کر امیر المومنین اذان دے رہے ہیں اور اس ملعون کو بیدار کر رہے ہیں جو اس خزد کے ساتھ اس مسجد میں آیا ہے کہ رسول کے جانشین کا قتل کر دے, اور یہاں تک کہ وہ بھی بیدار ہو جاتا ہے جیسے ہی امیر المومنین مصلے پر جاتے ہیں اور جیسے ہی نماز شروع کرتے ہیں اور جیسے ہی امیر المومنین رکوع کی طرف بڑھتے ہیں, ایک مرتبہ شقی اپنی زہر آلودہ تلوار لے کر وہ وار کرتا ہے کہ امیر المومنین مسجد کوفہ پر زمین پر آ جاتے ہیں, لیکن جب کوئی زمین پر آتا ہے قسم آج علی کامیاب ہو گیا آج علی کامران ہو گیا علی کو ضربت لگی اور آسمانوں میں صدائیں بلند ہونے لگی کہ ایمان کے ارکان ٹوٹ پڑے انبیاء رونے لگے ملائکہ رونے لگے لیکن حسن آتے ہیں مولا کی مدد کو آتے ہیں شخی کو پکڑنے کے لیے جاتے ہیں تسلی دی جاتی ہے لیکن عزیزو کرملا میں عصر عاشور علی کا لال حسین جب عصر عاشور زمین پر آ رہا تھا تو کوئی تلوار چلا رہا تھا کوئی گرز لگا رہا تھا کوئی تسلی دینے والا نہیں تھا اور یہ سب نے بغض ابھی کہہ کر یہ مار کر رہے تھے یہاں تک کہ حسین اپنی ماں کو صدا دیتے ہیں اما آئیے طفلی کے وعدے کو وفا کرنے کے لیے حسین زمین پر آ گیا سَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَنْقَلَبُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ بارِ الٰہی تو اس ہماری خلیل عزاداری کو قبول فرما ہمیں کوئی غم نہ ہو سوائے غم حسین کے جملہ مومن و مومنات کے حاجات کو بر لا جو مقروض ہو ان کے قرضوں کو ادا فرما تعجیل فرما ظہور قائم آل محمد آج دعا افتتاح کے بعد یتیموں کے سلسلے میں جو ہے ایک پروگرام ہے یہاں پر جو عراق کے لبنان کے یتامہ ہیں ان کے لیے جو ہے فن ریزنگ کی جا رہی ہے آپ زیادہ سے زیادہ تعاون کیجئے خصوصاً یہ شب اس کی ہے جو یتیم پرور تھا اور روایتیں بھری پڑی ہیں کہ کس طریقے سے امیر المومنین یتیموں کا خیال رکھتے تھے اور جب امام کی شہادت ہوتی واقع ہوتی ہے تو جب پتا چلتا ہے کہ کتنے یتیموں کو امیر المومنین شب کی تاریکی میں جا کر ان کی مدد کرتے تھے کتنی بیواؤں کی مدد کرتے تھے ایک سورہ فاتحہ تمام مرحومین کی ارواح کے لئے Yeah.